The gleaming steel scissors glide effortlessly through the sheet of red material, slicing through as if nothing was there. The blood-red fabric parts to either side. A pair of hands pick up one of the pieces and hold it up into the air. The man admires his handiwork before draping the cloth on a dress form and pinning it in place. Although there are many tables in the large room with sewing machines and mannequins next to them, they're all empty. The man works all alone in the big room. And it is impossible not to notice that he's an incredibly handsome man, too. So good-looking that no matter your preferences, you can't help but stop and take notice of his perfect facial features, his slim, fit physique, his lithe, dexterous hands. He brushes a strand of dirty blonde hair away from his vibrant blue eyes and takes a pin out of his mouth before adjusting the fabric just a millimeter more before sticking it in place. The man steps away from the dress form and admires his work. There. Absolutely perfect. There's no doubt that this will be the closing look of the upcoming fashion show. Another masterpiece. Just like him. But that doesn't mean that he's finished. There's still much to be done, and he goes back to work at his table, sewing bits of fabric together to create embellishments for the opulent couture gown. He's so focused on his new design that he doesn't notice the fashion house's operating manager in the hall outside of the workroom. The manager points through the glass window in the door and tells the two police officers with him that this is the man they're looking for. There's been a number of tragic and mysterious crimes involving people connected to this fashion company, and the police have finally closed in on a suspect. Well, not the police exactly, but two SCP Foundation agents posing as police officers. The Foundation became suspicious after learning that there had been several missing persons, murders, and mental breakdowns, all of which involved people connected to this one company. And even more specifically, they were all connected to one man. There was plenty of evidence that something more than just regular criminal activity was happening here. Something strange was happening. Something anomalous. One of the police officers nods at his partner before gesturing for the manager to leave. It's always better not to have civilians present during a containment. The incredibly handsome man still hasn't noticed his guests in the hall, remaining completely absorbed in his work, and he doesn't even look up when the two agents burst into the room, both with guns drawn, not taking any chances. "Freeze! Drop your weapon!" one of the agents shouts, but the beautiful man doesn't respond and just continues snipping away at fabric with his scissors. "I said freeze!" he commands again, and this time, the handsome man at least appears to have heard them, finally stopping his work. He slowly looks up with his piercing eyes to gaze at the men who have intruded into his creative workspace. "Drop your weapon now," the agent tells him. The man looks over at his hand, which still holds the large pair of scissors, and smiles. He gently places the scissors down on the table, careful not to let them touch the expensive cloth that is rolled out before him. "Now put your hands up!" This time, there's no response, and the man grips the edge of the table, smiling, and stares into the eyes of the agents, first one, then the other. "Hands up or we'll be forced to shoot!" The smile slowly leaves the handsome man's face. "Will you excuse me for one moment?" he says, though with no hint in his voice that it's actually a request. The agents seem unsure of what to do. Both of them appear taken aback and confused by his nonchalant attitude. The handsome man turns away from the agents and quickly steps behind a dressing screen that's been set up near his work table. As he walks behind it, he doesn't break his stride at all. He simply passes behind the screen for mere seconds and steps out on the other side. Only once he steps out, it isn't him anymore. The man that emerges from behind the screen is a completely different person. Where once he was slim, graceful, clean-shaven, and dressed in a fine suit, now he is heavy and muscled, like a professional football player, with a thick beard and dressed as if he's a member of a SWAT team. Before the agents can even react to the bizarre metamorphosis, the large man charges them and begins attacking. He snaps the neck of one and plunges the scissors he snatched off the table into the other's neck. More SCP containment specialists, these ones dressed in tactical gear with no attempt made to disguise themselves as everyday police, flood into the room and open fire. But the man who looks like a Navy SEAL picks up the fallen agent's guns and begins firing both at the same time. He outguns and outmaneuvers the agents, effortlessly rolling behind cover while constantly firing, taking out agent after agent. Screams fill the air, both from the dying SCP agents as well as the civilians who are struck through the walls by the onslaught, including the manager, who had snuck back to the door window to watch what he thought would be the snobby, handsome man being taken into custody. The window behind the special ops soldier explodes, and two SCP agents rappel through, catching him by surprise and knocking him to the ground. It takes even more agents rushing in to hold the man down as he struggles and screams like a wild animal, breaking one of their jaws for good measure before they're finally able to subdue him and confine him with heavy-duty straps. When all is said and done, 17 agents and 10 civilians have lost their lives, but the anomaly has finally been contained. Once it is taken to a secured location, it is given a new designation, SCP-056, but the site staff soon give it a new nickname, calling it simply, a beautiful person. SCP-056 is one of the most deceptive and one of the most dangerous anomalies known to the SCP Foundation. It is a being whose size, gender, and appearance can all vary in an instant, and which will change in response to its environment. The form it has most commonly taken while in containment resembles a man who appears to be in his mid-20s. His exact looks will vary slightly, but he will always be what could be described as incredibly handsome, at least by traditional societal standards. His clothes will change as well to be a style similar to those of other people around him, though they will always be of a higher quality and more aesthetically pleasing than anyone nearby is wearing. While that appears to be SCP-056's preferred form, it's far from its only one. In addition to the young man, it has also been observed taking on the appearance of several others, including a woman with a striking resemblance to Hollywood actress Scarlett Johansson, a form it took when walking past a group of a younger female staff, a male bodybuilder who could bench press over 250 kilograms, which was 30 kilograms more than the strongest security guard stationed at the Foundation site. It took the form of a female doctor who was measured as having an IQ score 30 points higher than any on-site researchers, as well as non-human forms, like a large, well-groomed Labrador retriever when it was exposed to another researcher's dog, and an extremely aesthetically pleasing couch when left alone in its own containment chamber. These changes from one form to another occur whenever people lose focus on the subject, something that seems to happen when new people are exposed to SCP-056. And once they lose focus, it's able to change in appearance virtually instantaneously. Attempts to film the transformation have resulted in the recording equipment exhibiting the same effect, seemingly losing focus, and being unable to see exactly what happens when SCP-056 changes from one form to another. Its clothing will change along with its bodily form, though so far it hasn't been observed manifesting weapons or other tools. Great efforts have been made to determine SCP-056's original form, though so far, these have all been met with failure. When placed within an empty concrete cell and placed under constant video surveillance, the cameras experienced the same loss of focus that others did, and then were met with a rather surprising figure left in the room. SCP-056 had taken the form of a video camera, similar to the one being used to record it, though a slightly more advanced and expensive model. Additional attempts were made to discover its true form, this time without direct observation equipment, with researchers instead making use of passive scans that could detect changes to life forms. When they left SCP-056 alone and monitored it using these tools, what they found was nothing. There was no detectable body temperature, heartbeat, or even weight. It appeared that when not observed, SCP-056 simply ceased to be. Those who have personal contact with SCP-056 often report that the anomalous entity makes them feel substandard or jealous, as if they can't measure up to it, yet at the same time will seem to seek its approval. This extends to SCP security staff, who will express a desire to follow its commands, while researchers will try to argue with it, something that usually results in them leaving its containment cell feeling as though they were outwitted by its intelligence. And SCP-056's expert communication abilities seem not to be limited by complex subjects or language barriers. Research has shown it to be fluent in at least 200 different dialects, and it has exhibited an expert level of knowledge in such varied topics as fashion, automobiles, theoretical science, sports, and a multitude of others, all of which it will usually show a greater knowledge of than the person it is conversing with. And despite leaving the conversations feeling dejected about their own abilities, those who talk to it will almost always express a desire to speak with SCP-056 again, as if they can't resist being made to feel inadequate by it. A number of tests were then performed to discover just what form SCP-056 would take when presented with various situations, and the results were rather interesting. In the first, a male Class D personnel was given a knife and told to try and attack SCP-056. 056 quickly took the form of a young, fit man who was able to effortlessly disarm the attacking D-Class and killed him with the knife instead. In another test, a female D-Class entered its cell not with a weapon, but with a bottle of expensive wine. They were met with SCP-056 in the form of a young, beautiful woman who accepted the wine, but upon trying it, spit it out in the D-Class's face and sent them away. Next, researchers sent two D-classes in at the same time, one male and one female, with no specific orders at all. SCP-056 appeared as a beautiful woman in a well-tailored business suit, who proceeded to examine both the D-classes, pointing out their each and every physical flaw before sending them two on their way. Researchers then tried sending 10 Class D personnel into the cell, all of whom were male and who had expressed a romantic preference for females. SCP-056 appeared as an especially beautiful female in a low-cut red dress. 056 didn't interact with the group in any way, but after 10 minutes, the D-classes began to look uncomfortable. Soon, an all-out brawl broke out between the D-classes as they violently assaulted each other, apparently for SCP-056's approval. 056 seemed to watch the melee with pleasure for several minutes before calling an end to it and sending them all out. A member of staff then volunteered to be tested with SCP-056, a level 4 personnel who was regarded as being especially beautiful herself. She entered SCP-056's cell, where the anomaly took the form of a similarly beautiful, professional-looking woman, and the two proceeded to have a conversation, discussing various advanced personnel management techniques. The discussion seemed amiable, but after 90 minutes, the staff member appeared to become infuriated with SCP-056 and quickly left the room. While no cross-tests with other SCPs have yet to be performed, when asked about other anomalies, SCP-056 shows a rare instance of vulnerability, expressing hatred towards them, and even occasionally, fear. SCP-056 has been relatively benign in its time in SCP containment, seemingly content to spend its time around Foundation staff. It's been allowed to have a cell of its own choosing, as well as pick its own furnishings, which have tended towards expensive and fashionable decor. Security staff assigned to guard it are equipped with high-powered tranquilizers, and any staff that exhibit mental irregularities after extended exposure to SCP-056 must undergo immediate psychological examination. It has frequently asked for access to the internet, and when asked why it desires that, SCP-056 responded that the Foundation was unable to provide it with enough sycophants, and that it wanted the whole world to know its face. Needless to say, its request for internet access was denied, and the anomaly, which has been classified as Euclid, continues to be securely cut off from the general public and remains in Foundation containment.